I just got a new iPad. Here's my old one. I want to get my stuff from here to here. How to back up and restore iOS devices. That's what we're talking about today. G'day, this is Doug from Doug's Hewson YouTube, and we're here to help you with tech wherever possible. Today we're talking about backup and restoring the trusty iOS devices. Great for when you get a new device, the iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, and we'll go into how you can do it through iTunes. There's some advantages to using iTunes, which we'll go into during the video. If you're into tech videos, how-to software tutorials and more, then why not consider clicking the subscribe button and check the bell notification so you don't miss the videos when I post them to the channel. So let's head on in to today's video. This is the information from the Apple support page that will help you step by step through the process of backing up and restoring your device. The first part of the process is backing up your existing iOS device. Connect your device to your computer. Open iTunes. Make sure you've got the latest version installed. Once it's ready to go, select the device at the top until you come to this screen. You'll see a section that says manually backup and restore. You want to click on backup now. And I recommend that you encrypt the backup because it will streamline the restore process. Now make sure you use a password. If you think you might forget it, write it down. You don't want to forget this password. Click backup now and let it backup. It'll tell you when it's done. After the process completes, make sure your backup is finished successfully. You can go and check if you like. You can see down the bottom it says latest backup, and it should have that time and date stamp to coordinate with that backup time. You can even go into iTunes preferences and in the devices tab, and you can see a list of all the backups on your computer. That backup should be listed in there under the name of your device and the time and date stamp. Once you've confirmed the backup, you can eject your device from iTunes and unplug it from your computer. Now, the next step is your iDevice, one that uses a SIM. If so, take the SIM out of the old one and put it in your new one. Now we're gonna transfer the backup and do a restore to your new device. So pick up your new device, turn it on, you'll get the Apple Hello Welcome screen. Start to go through that process until you get to the screen where it asks if you want to restore from a backup on iTunes. At that point, select that and hook it up to your computer, plug it in. Select the device in iTunes, go down and click the Restore from Backup button and step through that process, follow the on-screen prompts. That'll take a little while to do. Your new device may do some restarts, but just follow the prompts on both your computer screen and on your iDevice screen. Wait for the restore process to finish, and then the rest of the setup may have to be done on your iDevice once it's done. What you'll find is you might need to tap through some other options where you reconnect to your Wi-Fi and things like that. I recommend just leaving it plugged in. You know, you want to probably put some power into that iDevice anyway, so just leave it plugged in. And then what you'll find at the end, once you're on the screen, you might see the apps are still loading on. Now the apps are being reloaded from the App Store. They don't get backed up. The data gets backed up, but the apps themselves do not get backed up. So you'll find that you'll need to allow time for those apps to be reinstalled onto your new device. Eventually, all those apps will be reloaded. Once you've confirmed that your new device is set up and everything's on there, you can go back to the old device and wipe it clean. All you have to do is go to Settings, General, Reset, Erase All Content and Settings, and step through that process. It's gonna totally wipe your old iDevice back to factory settings. Be like brand new. So now you should have your new device all set up and your old device is wiped and ready for passing on to a new user or repurpose for your own use. Well, I hope that instructional tutorial was helpful to you. If you're ever considering restoring and backup from one iOS device to another, if it was helpful, give it a thumbs up. If you thought it sucked eggs, give it a thumbs down. And if it was very helpful to you and you want more things like this, and why not consider subscribing by checking the bell on the subscribe button below. That way you'll get reminded every time I post a video on my channel. And let's face it, I don't spam videos on my channel. They're not every day, but you might get one every week or two. question and comment of the day. Do you have any additional tips or tricks for your backup and restoring of your iOS devices, particularly on iTunes? And if you want more interesting iOS related videos, you can click this one right here. And here's another suggested video right here. And if you haven't yet subscribed and you want to, and you don't know where the red subscribe button is, why don't you just click this guy here. Well, this is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and I'm out.